Coping after tragedy, tonight the Wyandotte County Sheriff's Department is still trying to process the deaths of two deputies. That includes a man who supervised both deputies before a gunman took their lives.
41 Action News anchor Krista DuBille has the interview you will not see anywhere else.
Jeremy Walker was very close to the Wyandotte County deputies who died in the line of duty. The last 10 days have been difficult.
Professionally, I missed two of my best deputies. Personally, I missed two of the people I like seeing every day when I went to work.
Walker often helped Deputy Teresa King, who was a single mom. He spent time with King's 7-year-old daughter, Lexi, who clearly leaned on him during the funerals. You can see him holding her hand as they walk in, sitting with her during the funeral, and then walking out with her. He says both deputies' kids are doing as well as can be expected. Walker, who was the deputy's supervisor, says court transfers are typically one of the safest jobs in the department, and something like this can make you question your work.
I think everybody involved is at least questioning it. I mean, I think every time one of these things happens, everybody in that department steps back and questions if we can keep going forward. I think it'd be weird if we didn't. I mean, you don't expect this.
Walker is now heading up fundraising for the families. These are the hats they're selling now to raise money. The WC may be obvious, Wyandotte County, the SNO for Sheriff's Office. But the numbers, they're personal.
Once you're sworn in, you get a commission number. So that's our badge number. King is 1689, Roar was 1903. The numbers will never be reissued. There's nothing we could do to ever make up for the loss of what those families have given us. So the least we can do is make sure those children have a college fund.
Walker is the vice president of Wyandotte County Fraternal Order of Police number 40. He wants the community to always remember his colleagues and their families.
This wasn't Deputy King and Deputy Rohr. This was Teresa King and Patrick Rohr. I mean, at the end of the day, they went home to families.
Krista DuBille, 41 Action News.
Walker says the Fraternal Order of Police has seen some questionable fundraising for the families, so now they're vetting efforts to make sure that the money really goes to the families. They'll post all updates, including information on those hats that are now for sale on the FOP 40's website. And we have posted that link in this story at KSHB.com.